to get help. We have so many difficulties, so many challenges. We live in the world of duality, the world of opposites, and our emotions get in the way. When we leave here tonight, we need help. So what is out there to be able to help us? The expectations are so high. To be good, to be kind, to be compassionate, to serve our families, to serve humanity. And yet, we're not there yet. You know, we do a little here and a little there. So what resources do we have when we leave tonight to be able to be able to help us on our way?
Can I give a one-word answer? You. You have no other resources. Actually, honest truth. You know, there is no way any external thing can be useful when in any level of calamity inside us. Situations outside have not happened in one day. Something matured into that state, whether it is positive or negative. There is a beginning, there is a growth, and there is a culmination for everything. It's an evolution, right? So you can't change that course, even negativity for that matter. It rises, it stays, and it dies. Your positivity is the same. So what is your best bet here? You are the best bet. And how can you be very effective, most effective expression? Consistency, conviction, expression. You have to be very consistent in what you believe in, with conviction and expression. That becomes purpose, clear purpose, clean purpose. When I say purpose, it's a positive purpose, a purpose of regeneration, a purpose of love, kindness, compassion, all these things. That's the only way. And imagine, you inspire, you become sun and you become bright and you inspire other people to be bright. It becomes a movement, you see? It becomes a movement, and that's the best powerful movement. Centuries before, 1,000 years, 2,000 years ago, there was this writing you can call them astrological predictions about all the individuals which are going to take birth in this world. We call it nadis. In the southern state of Tamil Nadu, they've got a lot of that kind of thesis works. So these nadis had super accurate predictions because they are all thesis works. Masters who were consolidated, they became one unit and they were able to become universe. And from that angle, they have predicted these things will happen in the future. So one of those things which caught my attention, I was told, there was a small write-up about a person who will come in the future, thousands of years later, maybe 1,000 years later, not thousands, 1,000 years later. It said, at the time when the world believes in dressing up, there'll be a man who will surprise the world with his nakedness, and he will change the course of the history of this country. You know, Mahatma Gandhi, written at least 1,000 years before he was born. You know, and that man changed the course of the history of the country with what? Resilience, conviction. He knew what he was doing. He stood by it. By resisting, we may not change things. Resistance is good for negativity. It loves resistance. It stays stronger. When you resist something, that stays longer. Instead, you express what is the right way. For example, you are being loved continuously and it's visible in the society. People automatically get attracted to you. Why? Because this is pleasant. To be with love is much more pleasant than to be with anger, hatred, jealousy, all those kind of things. Revenge, all those things. Because it contracts you. It makes you dull. It makes you limited. But if you are connected to love, it expands. There is nothing to prove. It expands you. Freedom. Live freedom. That's what I'm saying. When we are constantly against something, we are always weak. So you have to bring up this love in the society and change the society from inside. It's important at this point in time. That's why I said, when you're looking at things outside to support you, what can support you? Nothing is permanent outside, even people. We ourselves have experienced that with people, right? Some people stay some time, some people stay slightly longer, some people come and go. Or some people stay forever. Very few people stay forever. So all these things are unpredictable. What is outside is unpredictable. If you want to make something predictable, that's only from within.
So Mahanji, what about the concept of guardian angels? And also, where does the essence of the guru principle enter?
Guardian angels are your complementing factors. When you are doing something, it accents you. Like for example, you are being in a particular state, that state is complemented by factors associated with that frequency. You are in a particular frequency, similar frequencies support you, protect you. Then guru principle is the guide principle which is within you, right? It's a state you achieve where you are having the larger awareness. That larger awareness, stability, mirror, state of being a mirror, that happens to you. That is the guru principle which everybody has, all of us have. That state comes to you from within.
Thank you.